class. Can I have you all stand on your feet? We're gonna get ready for the day. All right, so I need everyone to reach for the sky, reach as high as you can, bend back a little bit, put your head to the ceiling. Now reach down to your toes, like feel that stretch, wake up your body. All right, we'll do some like side to side, kind of stretch. All right, wiggle out all your jiggles, shake it, shake it, shake it. All right, you may sit down. Thank you. All right, today we're going to learn about thesis statements. So I don't know how these words make you feel, but hopefully by the end of the day, you will feel confident about your ability to make thesis statements. All right, so first, there we go. We will start with our learning target. Morgan, will you stand and read our learning target for today?
I will analyze thesis statements and create my own.
Thank you. All right, so a learning target is something that we as a class will all be aiming for. So it's my goal for you to be able to do this, and it's your goal as well. So first, what is a thesis statement? I'm going to give you roughly 30 seconds to write down any words that come to mind when you hear a thesis statement, any associations, emotions, a definition, anything you want. So go. Right, 10 seconds. All right, I need 3 volunteers to read what they wrote. Afka.
I wrote argument, your opinion, the main point in the intro of the paper.
Nice. All right, someone else. Courtney.
I said it was the topic, kind of like a summation point. It's involved in the intro and the closing of your piece. It's normally concise, brief, and clear.
Nice. All right, one more person. Morgan?
I wrote topic, narrow, and difficult to come up with.
Oh, okay. Good. I like that. All right, so for a thesis, you all touched on this. You have a great foundation for learning about this. So it presents the main idea or claim of your paper. So when you're writing about something, you want the reader to know where you're going. And you also have to have a main idea that the rest of your paper will support. So the thesis is key to successful writing. And I want all of you to be successful writers. So we're gonna be working on this today. So some keys to a great thesis. It has to make a claim. You can't just say Shakespeare wrote about Romeo and Juliet. That's a fact, right? So it has to be debatable. You could say, Shakespeare wrote about love in Romeo and Juliet, and this is how we should love each other today. Now that's debatable. I think a lot of people could disagree with that statement. All right, and so again, this is something that you'll support with the rest of your essay. So it has to be something that you're interested in, something that is researchable, and is something that you can support. You also don't want to say the moon doesn't exist, because how can you support that? And also, like I think Courtney said, it has to be precise, clear. You don't want to be vague. It wants to be something that's very clear for the audience to understand. Okay, so now we're going to spend the last minute having a chant so that we can remember this. So I will do the chant first, and then I'll have everyone stand up and follow me. So this is something to help you remember these 3 points. Okay, so it's in counts of 4. So you go, stop, check your thesis. Does it make a claim? 1, 2, 3, 4. Is it debatable? 1, 2, 3, 4. Is it precise? 1, 2, 3, 4. And that's it, okay? So everyone stand up. We're gonna practice. Courtney, you're a cheerleader, so this is probably embarrassing, but. All right, so we're gonna do it together. So first, what do you do? Stop, check your thesis. Does it make a claim? Is it debatable? 1, 2, 3, 4. Is it precise? All right, very good. You may be seated. That's something we'll do again at the end of the class.